Summary resolution. Death does not come randomly to China's orphans, but is the result of a conscious decision by orphanage staff to deprive a particular infant or group of infants of care. According to Dr. Chen, this procedure is known as summary resolution, and it is carried out as follows. Whenever the number of children in a ward exceed a certain level, the child care workers agree among themselves to bring the population back to normal by eliminating some of their little charges. A collective decision will be made that certain orphans, because they are smaller or weaker than others, or because they have some congenital abnormality, are medically unviable. Food and water are then withheld from those targeted, making the decision of unviability a self-fulfilling prophecy. After several weeks of deliberate neglect, with the child's health rapidly failing, senior medical staff at the orphanage will be called in. Their role is not to save the children's lives, but rather to validate the earlier staff's decision of unviability by providing a convincing medical diagnosis. As in the case histories recounted previously, these doctors usually fall back upon one of a small number of pseudo medical concepts, such as congenital maldevelopment of brain or third degree malnutrition, to explain the child's imminent demise. The childcare workers then transfer the child to the dying room without fear of reproach, knowing that they have a medical cover for their homicidal neglect.
We'd started our journey believing that specific rooms are set aside for abandoned babies to die. But here there was no time to separate the dying from the rest. This whole building is their dying room. The 80 or so lives that ended here last year passed unnoticed, unremembered, and unmourned. A woman who already had one child when the police discovered she was pregnant without permission told us about her enforced abortion.
She wants to make other one. And now she has a baby in her body for 5 months. So the policeman and this lady catch this lady to the hospital. Take the baby from her. She put the medicine inside, so the baby is dying.
And it kills the baby?
Kill the baby. Take the baby out.
She said that at the same time as the doctors gave her an abortion, they also sterilized her.
In China, we have credible reports of women being locked up, incarcerated, until they submit to an abortion, of women being aborted or sterilized during the course of other medical procedures without their foreknowledge or permission, of their husbands being arrested or actually imprisoned until their wives submit to abortions, of babies being killed at birth by means of a lethal injection into the fontanelle, that is the soft spot of the child's skull, of couples having their electricity or their...
While we were filming, we made a grim discovery. There was a room here where a baby girl had been left to die 10 days ago. The staff preferred not to enter the room, waiting instead for one of the other children to report that the infant had died.
Look at this body. Oh, God, Peter. Very sad. It's so inhuman that I can't believe. If it is a boy, they will try their best to save him. But because she's a girl, so she's left to die. She's waiting to die.
We asked her name and were told Mei Ming. This means no name. It was the second time in her short life that she'd been abandoned. Mei Ming gave up her fight for life 4 days after we filmed her. She died of plain neglect.
Despite all this, the various costs and consequences of the one-child policy are so poorly understood that it continues to get plaudits, especially from environmentalists. For years, the Communist Party has asserted that the policy averted between 300 and 400 million births, about the size of the American population. Such claims are now suspect. Some demographers estimate the real number of births averted was probably 100 to 200 million at most. That's a lot, but it's still dwarfed by the Communist Party's pronouncements. To be sure, fewer births made investments in human capital more efficient. Less spreading out of educational resources, for example. Many economists, however, agree that China's rapid economic rise had more to do with Beijing's moves to encourage foreign investment and private entrepreneurship than a quota on babies. Privatizing China's lumbering state-owned enterprises, for example, spurred private sector growth until it accounted for as much as 70% of China's gross domestic product by 2005. Arthur Kroeber, one of the most prolific and respected economists who specializes in China, said, "Let's say China grew 10%. I would be surprised if more than 0.1% of this is due to the one-child policy."